Good morning, everybody. Happy Tuesday. Okay, so today I'm going to talk to you about something I love talking about. So there's three different steps to this, and it's all about being resilient. So there's three steps. Each day I'm going to share a step with you. Each time I come live, I'll try the next 3 days. And today is all about having a positive attitude. And for some reason, that sentence, it's having a positive attitude can be so cliche. Like, I talk to so many people and I'm like, you have to have a positive attitude. You have to just push past those struggles you're going through and do something good for you and find the love in your life. And they say, well, it's just too hard. It's just too hard and tough. Or they'll be like, yeah, okay, whatever. And for me, this is what's helped me be resilient, this first step. This is what's changed my life, is having a positive attitude. For so long, and especially for us women, I don't know about men because I'm not a man, but I'm sure it's kind of the same situation, but maybe different in a story. But I guess this story kind of would be towards a woman, because as kids, as little girls, we grow up thinking about that happily ever after. Like, how many of you grew up in the 80s, 90s, 70s even, and watched all the Disney movies, the princess movies, and there's this happily ever after. Don't get me wrong, I am like all about the Disney movies and I love the happily ever after. But when you grow up and realize real life has real life struggles, and situations that you need to overcome, that happily ever after isn't there. And we're always looking, I've talked about it before, we're always looking for the grass is greener on the other side. Nothing is ever good enough. And we start to go into a negative mindset where nothing's ever good enough, we want something more, it's harder to get through struggles. And when you focus on a struggle so hard, and I have focused on a struggle so hard that it's literally emotionally debilitating. And I know it is for so many people. And what I've learned, so I'm feeling a little nauseous this morning. What I've learned is that you have to always look at the positive. Yes, something crappy might be happening, but look at what it's going to teach you. We get through it, right? And I'm talking about everyday struggles in life. I'm not talking about the real hard stuff. That's something I can't comment on because I'm not a therapist. I'm just talking about my situations I've been through in my life and struggles. So let's talk about, hey, Emma. Emma, right? Yes, hi, Emma. Sorry, I'm not wearing my glasses. Let's say you have this struggle. Maybe it's, you're going through a breakup with a loved one. I have been there, and you feel emotionally just done. You're just emotionally done. You're sad, you're angry, you're grieving. There's so many emotions that come up with a breakup. It can be debilitating as well. And you can't see that light at the end of the tunnel. You're looking at all the negatives and maybe you're forgetting the positives as the reasons to why this is happening. Sometimes you have to, for me, I have to look at the bright side. Think about the fact that you're going through something that you know you're going to make it to the other side. And maybe you don't see that happiness on the other side, but you have to find the happiness in you at that moment. And maybe that happiness is the fact that maybe it's an abusive relationship you're getting out of. Or maybe it's just a relationship that you both know isn't good for both of you. Or maybe it's just you don't want to be with that person anymore. Look at the positive side of that, moving forward, continuing your life, finding your happiness. Maybe it's a huge bill or something. Maybe it's a massive bill. We all get bills, let's be real. Maybe it's a massive bill and you're like, shit, I don't know how I'm gonna pay that bill, right? So just chip away at it. Chip away at it as much as you can. And know that it's okay and it's a positive thing that you're putting $20 or $100 or whatever it is on that bill that's making you so stressed out. And I find what happens is, for me, and I'm sure for a lot of you, when we focus on, oh my God, I don't know how I'm going to do it. Oh my God, I don't know how I'm going to get through this. What am I going to do? Who's going to help me? All these things where we're not seeing our happily ever after. Why isn't this happening for me? Why can't it happen for me? Why don't I have this? Why can't I do that? You're always thinking about what's on the other side, and you're not actually achieving it because you're staying stuck in a place of, this isn't good enough and it's never going to get better. And you're going to constantly think that because your thoughts create your vision. That's just it. Your thoughts create your vision. If you want to stay stuck in a really crappy place, then let your thoughts go negative. But I'm here to tell you, you can't. You have to have a positive attitude. You have to know that if you want your happily ever after, you have to look inside you for your happiness. You can't think about, you know, maybe I need to lose 10 or 30 pounds. I want this house. I need to do this. I want this. I want that. You can't think about all the things you want and not take action on them. You have to be happy with who you are in the present moment and know, like, you've all been through struggles. You've all been through struggles. And you can all tell me right now, have you been through a struggle? I want to see below. Have you been through a struggle and overcame it? Something so small. It could be something so small. Have you overcome a struggle? Of course you have. So every struggle you go through, use that as a learning tool for your next struggle, because it's going to happen. They happen every single day, but you have to know that you're going to get over that struggle. Good morning, Tracy. That's something I've actually learned to do really well, especially when we lost our business. That was emotionally draining. Like, we were drained emotionally, financially, in every possible way. And to find my happiness, I worked on me. We went to the gym every single day for 2 hours for 2 years, every single day. There was no excuse in my world that would stop me from creating my happiness, because I know if I sat around and did nothing and stayed in my own negative thoughts, that my happily ever after wouldn't happen, because happily ever afters don't just happen. You have to take action. And if something is making you negative, you need to learn from that struggle and make it a positive and know, like, I knew we were going to get over that hurdle. Like, it's going through those struggles and overcoming them over and over and over again and learning from them and knowing when that same struggle comes up again that, hey, I did that and I came out totally fine and I was like super happy for like 6 months. Why would I allow that to stress me or emotionally suck me dry for the month that, you know, maybe that struggle's happening for? Why would I let that ruin my happiness for a whole month, right? So you have to continuously have a positive attitude to be resilient. And as you do that, you'll find your resilience will come out more. You'll be more positive, and that struggle won't last as long as the last time. Each struggle will last less and less and less because you're changing your mindset. And if you need help to change your mindset, all you gotta do, go to YouTube, search like positive mindset, anything like that, and you can definitely create a more positive mindset by doing that, especially when you're going through struggles. Because if what I do, okay, what I do, every day I see the light in everything. Every single day I see the positivity in everything. But when I'm having really down days, which they happen, especially us ladies, we get our periods, that's about to happen for me, hence the nausea, you have to like almost dig into it more. Like, I will probably do 2 to 3 hours more of personal development, and I'm a little crazy like that. But you could do, maybe you've never done personal development, go search a YouTube video and do 30 minutes of personal development, which is inspiration videos or videos. Maybe you're having a hard time with friends, how to have better relationships, like anything. Search anything that you need help with to give yourself a more positive mindset in that certain situation, and it will guide your mind to feeling better. So that is my first tip on how to be resilient, and 2 more videos coming up probably over the next few days. I hope it helps you. And if you need any help at all or just a girlfriend to chat with, just shoot me a message, comment below. But I want to know below, have you ever been through a struggle and did you overcome it? Have a great day, guys. See ya.